Hey, that's me, and today I'm gonna show you how to do this, this, and this. And you don't need a crazy good PC. The CPU, well, it's a 1 out of 5, cause NAS emulations are pretty easy to run. And a GPU, well, a 1 out of 5 again, cause you don't even need a 500 megabytes of free RAM. But there's a special requirement for today, and that's the Molecular Script from Scorpio81. There's a download link for that in the description. So let's jump into the tutorial. So we're in, let's delete pretty much everything except the main camera. Zero it out by pressing N and, well, zeroing it out. Pretty much everything except, well, the X-axis. We want 90% on that and shift it back a bit by pressing G for, well, grabbing it. And so we just need to move the camera back and add some spheres. Some UV spheres right here. And, well, copy pasting them all over the place by using Control C and Control V and scaling it by pressing S till we've got a desired look. And obviously it's helpful to go inside of the camera by pressing 0 on a numpad. So if you've got your desired look by copy and pasting all those spheres around, press right click on them and then join them all together so it's one big object, so it's a little more easy to work with. Now let's start with the particle simulation. Theoretically you could use any mesh you want. I'm just going to use an icosphere to emit the particles. Yes, we're going to use particles for that. Now we got the mesh outside of the view and we want to emit particles from it. So let's go into the particle properties and add a particle system. Now that's important. The time pretty much means when it starts generating all those particles. So right now it's from frame 1 to 200. And as you can see, it's emitting a lot of particles. We don't want that though. Let's go down to 1. So every single particle is there immediately. As you can see, they all bounce out of there. So we don't want any gravity to affect those particles because that looks kind of bad, I guess. I don't know. Maybe it could look cool, but in this case, we don't want it. So we go into force fields and turn it down. And now theoretically, you could turn the gravity curve off completely. But if you have more elements in the scene, which should be affected by gravity, you might don't want to do it. Theoretically, you could use it. You could do that in the scene properties and just disable the gravity. I'm just going to do it in the particle system itself. So we disabled it. They don't float anywhere except away from the sphere. And don't live too long, sadly, because, well, the lifetime is too short. Let's increase it to 250. Let's play it back and there we go. There are the particles. They survive for 250 frames. We are happy. So right now, we couldn't really see what those particles look like if you'd rendering. So we need to change stuff. Let's go back into the particle system, go to the render tab and change it to object because we want to render our spheres. So let's just add some spheres, some more UV spheres. We just need one. And again, place them somewhere where we can't see it. The balls are called particles, of course, because I just named it that way. And we can see they float away. Now we want to kind of animate that. And if you want to do that, we can use force fields by just using the force. So press Shift A, go down to the force fields and use the force like in Star Wars. Okay, right now the particles will hate it. The force will just throw them away from itself. So we need to go to the strength and make it go negative, so it's gonna get sucked in. All those particles, as you can see, are gonna go, gonna get sucked in by a force. Okay, that's okay, but the particles right now don't interact at all with our glass balls, with our geometry. That's pretty easy to fix. Just go into the physics properties and turn on collisions. Let's go back to the first frame, and there we go. They interact with it. Theoretically, we could change stuff, but in this case, it's glass. It's not gonna stick or anything. So we're gonna stick with the normal values for that. So right now, it kind of looks okay, but the problem is the particles itself, they don't actually interact with each other. As you can see here, they intersect pretty much everywhere. And it's pretty easy to fix. If we go into the particles again on our emitter, and use the molecular script and activate self-collision so they will hopefully collide with each other. Let's start the animation and we can see, oh my god, they explode. Because, well, they start out being intersected. That makes them explode and we can change that. By not letting them emit from the faces, let's
let them emit from the volume. So let's let them emit from the volume. Let's go there. And while we're there, let's just say it's a grid. As you can see, they're all not intersecting anymore, so they're not gonna explode. So let's try it. Let's start the simulation, and there we go. They don't explode. They just interact with stuff. Now they kind of look uniform right now. They're looking like they're all the same boss. We can change that though. Let's go into the render settings again. And change the scale. We can make them bigger and add some randomness. Let's simulate it again. And there we go. Now it looks a little more random. A little better. At least that's what I think. Right now, they still pretty much explode on impact, which doesn't look that awesome. But we can change that. Or, well, fix it. By increasing the flow value, which pretty much means it's dampening. I think. It just damps the particles. It's not actually damping it, but like, it gives it this effect, and they don't explode too far apart. So let's just simulate it again by again pressing start molecular simulation and see what happens. Yeah, there we go. That looks a bit better. We could pretty much just increase it, the flow value even further. Let's go with 2. Why not? Let's see if that's better. Start simulation. And there we go. It's a lot more smooth. Okay, perfect. Another gather in the middle. But that's kind of lame. So let's just make it move around. Let's take the force field. Press right click on the coordinates or on the location. Insert a keyframe. Go somewhere else. And the next frame, it's gonna go. Oh, let's go over there. And then after 90 frames or so, new keyframe, 91, and move it down there. And then, oh, maybe there, keyframe, and move it. So it's not a smooth animation, it's just popping somewhere else. So the particles find their own way to get there, and they're not all just in one ball and follow the force field. Okay, that looks good. Let's just start a molecular animation again, or simulation. And there we go. We can see them follow it. Well, the force field. Yeah, kind of looks good. Oh, yeah. Perfect. And at the end, I gather around this one sphere. Why not? It looks good, I'd say. Okay, now, if you go into render tab, in the render properties, we could use Eevee. It's not that good looking, I'd say. Let's go into cycles. Change it to GPU, and I'd recommend GPUs, because S is going to take a long time to render. So, if we'd render it, it would look like this. Everything is gray and lame, and that looks bad. Let's go in world properties and just make the whole world black so we don't see anything. And, well, add a light source. More specific, a area light, because that's nice and big, and it can be easily reflected by all those glass balls. And well, let's just change the size of it. Let's make it a bit longer, a little thicker, and well, and put it a bit further up so we don't see the light source. And make it a bit more powerful. Let's go to 500 or something like that. Yeah, that looks better. Maybe let's make it a bit thinner, why not? Okay, there we go. So we got that. No, it's still pretty much just white. It looks boring. So let's just make the boss be glass. By going into this shader editor, add a new shader and pretty much just use the principal shader because it's the best one. It's the most physically accurate shader there is. And add some transmission. Turn down the roughness and the specular because that's not realistic. And right now, the glass balls don't look like actual balls. They're not that round. So let's make them look round by shading them smooth. And there we go. We've got balls. That sounds wrong. But there we go. They pretty much look like glass balls right now. And that's awesome. We kind of want that. Now, time for some wake-up coffee. Okay, there we go. Now the balls itself that are emitted and bounce all around still look pretty boring. So let's select the particles over here, not the actual particles, but the object of the particles, and add a shader to them. Now in this case,
we want it to emit light.
So in the mission tab, you can just increase
the light.
No, lighten it up by, well, bringing it up to white and change the colors. But right now, it's just one color. That's kind of boring. So let's just press Shift A and search for object info. There we go. We got an object info. And there's a small little thing called random. So there's a random color for every single object in this, in every single instance of the object. And if you add that to the emission shader, nothing will happen. Because right now it's just a factor value. So it's black and white. And as you can see, if we zoom in on it, there are some different shades of gray pretty much right now. But we don't want that. We want colors. So we need a color ramp right there. Do the same. Shift A, add a color ramp, and we can decide what it's supposed to look like. So let's just, I don't know, add some red, add a new one by pressing the plus, and blue, and this one should be green. Now there are a lot of different shades, so it's just like completely red, and then less red, it goes into purple, and then blue, and we don't want that actually. So you can change the way the gradient is a gradient. So we can just go to constant. As you can see, there are only, whoopsie doodles, those colors. Just red itself, blue itself, and green. And we pretty much got that. We can add that to the base color too. And we've got a glowing boss right now. And there we go. We got glowing boss. Isn't that awesome? And that's pretty much it. I just did that. As you can see, it's super easy. And it's not that hard to render. So that's pretty much it. We use GPU compute to render the whole image and wait till it's done. I'm just using 128 samples because you don't actually need that many samples. Because I'm going to show you a trick right now. And there we go, it's done rendering. It's okay, it's kind of grainy and we can get rid of that pretty easily. And we can just easily get rid of the noise in the image by using the interdenoiser, which is pretty new in the new Blender version. By going into the composite node, by adding the denoise node, there we go, and then add the denoise data in the, what's it called, view layer properties, and just connect the noise image, the denoising normal, and the denoising albedo, run it again. Wait till it's done. And there we go. A image. It took 20 seconds to render, so it's pretty easy on your hardware. It's just awesome. It looks good, at least in my opinion. Of course, we can like increase all those lights so it's brighter and all. But yeah, that's it. I hope you enjoyed that tutorial. If you did, leave a like. If you didn't, leave a dislike. Comment down below why you didn't like it, why you don't like it. If you loved it, sub to my channel and ring the bell, because I'm definitely going to upload a lot more tutorials on this channel. Yeah, that's it. Bye.